Our referee has awarded that for the corner. Well, St. Peter's up against Murias. Will be an interesting game coming up a little bit later. We will be able to see how far that will go anyway. Foul. Referee awards that. In a very much open-ended game here. Long ball forward. Throw. Sent in very quickly there. Now collected here by Atimango, but the ball just easily glides away. Well, Ajax Queens will be looking very quickly to see if they can get something from this game. And the referee says Anyonjo's throw was a little bit poor. Well, possibly it will be a chance for them to get this ball forward again. Looking to deliver. Who brought in by Anena.
Okay.
Kayongo fighting with that ball. Now collected again in the D. Repossessed perfectly, but now finally gotten away.
Yeah, that was Ajax Queens' undoing yesterday. They did defend poorly. They were shaky and were always under pressure when attacked. The same happens today. But because Vision have not found their way through, that's why we still have a stalemate after 4 minutes. But you could see the three dangerous attacks have come to their defense. Ajax Queens need to do better, close up the spaces and stop creativity at the midfield level.
This is a chance for Nachanzi to fight her way through, but again, off the legs of Nalubega. Anena. Sorry, that was Oyela Farida rather. Straight to the goalkeeper on the far side. Nakayondo Pamela. And brought back in the center path, and referee says, oh, you can actually get a yellow card for that, Arach. Need to be very careful. But that's how it stands so far.
Yeah, Fiona is being a little careless. Sometimes as early as this, you need to have your head in one place. Apparently, being disappointed and kicking the ball away is very bad for you to get a booking as early as this. That means that you'll have to play cautiously for the rest of the minutes. But it's a long free kick from the backside for Ajax Queens.
Well, they're still fighting for the same ball around the center park. And that was Atimango. Loses possession earlier on to Nakayongjo. Ball still in the center park now. Intercepted. It'll be a free kick. And a free kick coming up here for the Ajax Queen. Sorry, for the Vision side. Long ball to the far. Away by Akirol, who's actually playing a more of a defensive role in today's match, surprisingly, Akirol. Yesterday she played in the center, but today she's playing defensive. Solid. That's Akulu Sharon. Another interesting footballer there for the Vision side. It's a game that can actually go anywhere. You just have to keep your eyes here.
But Ajax Queens need it more because they have to throw in everything they have. That's why you mentioned the tactical reshuffle for Akirol to help out in the defense, because their defense looked a little bit porous. They left a lot of gaps. They need someone who is a bit mobile, very fast to clear away from danger, and has very good game reading antics. Otherwise, if they let it happen like it did yesterday against Amoria, lost concentration, and at the end they succumbed to Emanuela's late goal. So today they have to be very careful, and I think the coach knows it. An attempt at goal.
Oh, good save there from Pamela. Very, very good save. Again, Atimango was the player that was going in hard. Well, she's been a very good goalkeeper, Pamela Nakayondo. And just reminding you that this is a battle of Bulenga versus the one and only Kitgum. It's interesting.
Bulenga is Wakiso.
Yeah, hopefully.
If my geography can save me from this, Bulenga should be Wakiso. Yeah. Wakiso is very big. Chereka. Yeah, Blenga is Wakiso. Nansana. I think we are right on that.
So, chance away to Atimangwa a while ago.
But did you keep an eye on her? Yeah, she's very good. Stops that. She's been outstanding.
Still a very much opened game, so we just can't rule it away as they continue to pile up. That's good play there from Bernadette a while ago. Fortunately, the ball just easily glides away for a throw in here. Akirol shall be the one to get on with this. Long from Akirol. And finally booted away there by the lady herself, Amongin. Another throw in. Akirol. And gifted team not reaching on that ball. Intercepted again. Cleared away there by Sharon Nakayonjo. On the side now, Bernadette. Can they bring that ball back? This is good. And they easily miss on this. Could be a chance here. Oh, it's in.
It's inside.
That's a simple, simple goal to actually concede. And they finally put that ball in the back of the net. And you just cannot believe this. But it's just a number five, Namakula Ariziki.
Namakula Ariziki, after firing blanks yesterday, redeems herself by scoring a simple one. But clumsy goalkeeping. Clumsy goalkeeping from the vision goalkeeper. Alum, Irene, that is clumsy goalkeeping. It was a low-driven shot. It didn't have a lot of energy on it. She was standing where the ball went and apparently decides to fumble with it till it crossed the line. Oh, just look at that. Of course, there was pressure from the advancing Nachanzi Caroline, who was coming from the right side. But again, the goalkeeper had all the space to get the ball. Clumsy goalkeeping for me. One key area where these teams need to improve. Again, you just look at the cutbacks and then the finishing from Namakula. Superb, superb to give Ajax Queens a lead after 9 minutes of play.
Well, for the first time, the Ajax Queens have taken the lead in this competition. Yesterday, they actually had to come from behind to level up matters 2-2. But went on to lose that game 3-2 against Amuria High. But today they take the lead against Vision, a team that thumped St. Peter's 5-0. Game on. Away by Akirol. Collected here. That's a good play there from, that was Nalukuma. Well, this game can actually go anywhere, really. This one can go anywhere. Alum Irene will be very disappointed that she conceded that goal. But you can't actually not blame her. Slight deflection, it was caught her flat-footed. Away by Awiela. The chase is on now. This is a Caroline Nachanzi. But that just easily glides away. Another throw in here for Vision. Well, for the Ajax Queens, they need this win to actually stay in that competition. Awiela. Yela and Nena trying to drive that ball forward. Trying to deliver the ball through here. Well, still a very much
open game. As you can see, a throw-in coming in from Vision Football Club. Doesn't pay off, but again, they get another inconsistency. That's what they need. They await a quick reaction, and tactical adjustment could help them out. But Ajax Queens repair their side at the back. Yeah, yesterday they looked a little bit awful, if you remember. And now there is a corner coming in from Vision. Yeah. They have great headers of the ball.
There's just a slight confirmation. It was Margaret Nalube who actually scored that goal, Fiona. Just getting a right confirmation on that.
Okay.
It wasn't number 5. Namakula. It was number 15.
Nalubega.
Yeah, she's
Margaret,
a midfielder.
Yeah, midfielder coming from the midfield and got the ball very well and tried to nick in very, very well. Peter Otai, you must admit, she's given them hope. Redemption to try go for the 3 points, and the goalkeeper there, Pamela, going long. I just love the way she swings the left leg goalkeepers sometimes are very good with details, but normally lose to simple goals. And you think that's what happened yesterday, because her defense gave her away. They didn't cover her very well. That is why apparently they lost yesterday's game. Narrowly, they are trying to come back, but in this one, they need to take charge like they have done. We have a free kick at the backside.
Free kick here. All sent away, looking for the options. Brushed away at the midfield position. That was Aneno. Now the chest on by the big lady, Namwonge. Still fighting away through Namwonge. The assistance could be coming in from Nalukuma. Four they go, but the flag is offside. Well, that won't count there for Caroline Nachanzi.
She insists checking the net. Thinking when she does that, it will help Nachanzi. Caroline. I just love the organization, Peter, of the teams. We've seen all teams change sets of jerseys for the first two games, which was a problem in the past. A team would go on to use one jersey, and that was really very bad. But for now, that is just a reflection of how women football has grown. And apparently, was she offside? She came from the blind side.
Well, we actually have the different kind of view. Chance away, Namwonge allows that ball to roll out. Throw in here for Ajax. So the game continues to man up. Well, just a little bit of change between Akiror Patricia and Namogerwa Dorin. Corner. Oh, Nachanzi very, very close to receiving that. Would have been a gift for her. Atimango. Long ball from Nakayonjo. Repossessed again there by Ngozi. Collected by the captain, Oyela. It's good fighting. Very good fighting there from Sharon Nakayonjo. You can see Oyela not very happy about that. Long ball forward. Brushed away again. Anena Lucky putting that ball up front. Nalubega's goal is the one separating the two sides.
Yeah, that came in 19
just number
minutes.
15.
She was just very lucky. Keeper was not on her best day. And she got that in. If they can capitalize on that, well, good. But you can see they're improving up front. She shifts to the right.
Ngozi, very good play. Dropping that ball in the forbidden area here. And they can strike from distance. Or they can't. And that's a foul.
Yeah, she held the ball.
Yeah, poor play. Very, very poor play there from Penina Amongin. And from such distance, Fiona, we have actually seen goals scored here.
And from what we've seen from the goalkeeper, it means that they have to defend better. The wall should be ready to help out if the ball is within their reach. But we've seen very good strikes coming in from different players. The defenders sometimes become responsible for charge, so the goalkeeper will be called upon to action alone. Irene.
Free kick here for Vision. Well, this free kick is in a very good territory for a second, and standing on it is Maureen Nangozi. She'll be looking to
increase. She scored yesterday. She scored the second goal for them yesterday.
Maureen standing on this one. Goes for this. That's very poor. Well, you thought that with all the goals we have seen in this competition, maybe Nangozi would have scored that.
Yeah, I think she should give the next one to Namwenge. She has a bigger muscle and sometimes goes for color in the right direction.
Yeah, this is a free kick. Yeah. Look at that. Very poor play there from Among in Penina. Well, trust me, you have to keep your eye on these ladies from Kitgum. That's good control from Atimango. And good backtracking from Nakayonjo Sharon. Hope she hasn't picked up an injury there.
Nanyonjo.
Yeah, she came very hard, really. She came very, very hard.
Yeah, she came very hard, and there was contact, though the ball had already gone, so.
Well, she will be able to
shrug that off.
Hopefully. Because here we go. She comes hard. There.
Yeah.
It's painful.
Corner for Vision Football Club.
Did you see how she twisted her ankle?
Yeah. It's a little painful, and she needs to be lucky to get back on her foot. She does. Just waiting to defend the corner.
Oyela Kuna. Cut away, but not very away. Could be going back to Oyela. Well, good play there from the Ajax Queens. They've actually pushed the ladies from Kitgum away. Little touch. Ball goes out for a throw in. I'd like to say hello to all those who are watching this in Kitgum. The Kitgum women here are currently representing.
Yeah, and we thank those responsible for setting up the team. Free kick once again.
Yeah, that's the goal scorer, Nalubega Margaret.
Yeah.
Sent to the ground there.
And Vision is giving out too many free kicks in dangerous areas. Areas where we've seen goals scored from. Nalubega broke down, and now Namwenge, like I predicted, will be responsible for this one. Nangozi has been taken off that role temporarily.
Well, she scored yesterday, Namwenge, and she wants to score again. Ooh, deflection, corner.
She saves the team, but he thought it was a little dangerous and threatening. Meeting the ball just above the chest, sometimes the arms are there, is the reason we have the free kick, nipped from behind.
Well, a little bit of a injury concern here now for the ladies from Kitgum. The doctor has to come in very quickly to assess the situation here. Hope she'll be okay. We don't know exactly what transpired there.
Patricia Gwe.
Corner here for Ajax Queens. As we speak right now, the Vision ladies are basically 10. Brought in by Benedict. Back again to her. She beats one. Namwenge tries to lay through. Among in and away by the captain, Oyela Farida. Here they come. Namwenge. Among in. Another long ball there from the defender. Namakula. Still in the forbidden area, the ball is. Namwenge. Nachanzi. Oh, that's very close.
Narrowly missing. If she had curved it better, then Vision Group would be in a deficit of 2 goals. They are lucky it goes off.
You just call them Vision Group.
Jesus Christ.
A group of players, really. So no worries about that. Vision Group would also do.
I remember yesterday I called the goalkeeper Among Anita, and now Vision Group. Good. Well, it's commentary for you. And Peter Otai is here to give it to you in full throttle.
Oyela. Don't mind you. They're a group of players, so no worries. Can call them Vision Group too. Throw it. Well, just 20 minutes of this game played here, and game still locked on 1-0. Realize that Oyela Farida is actually playing almost every number now. She switches from striking to go and throw the ball on the right back position. And yet you do have Amogin Penina. I think she's the one who's still out getting some medical attention. Oyela looking for Arach. Stripped away there by Namugerwa. Collected perfectly at the midfield position. It's a long ball away. They're looking to the goal scorer, Nalubega. Well, I love the way Vision played yesterday when they won their game by 5. They scored 4 goals in the first half.
In the first half and when in the second half, they imposed themselves in the game, attacked all the time. But in this game, they're playing cautiously well. Ajax Queens could be, of course, given credit for improving because they were a very bad outfit in the first half.
The red shot there from Namwenge. It looks like Among in Penina may be coming back to continue this game. So it means that the captain Oyela will be going back to her possession. Still Oyela here. Oyela up against Namwenge. And Namwenge does well, putting good pressure on Oyela. And that goes out for a throw, which could be gone very quickly. Namwenge beats one here. Tries to be two, and she fouls in the process. Free kick. I'll be a word here for Namwenge. She's being told by the referee to come down. Just a number 4, Asiro Recho. Another interesting defender there for the Vision Queens.
Well, we continue to encourage a lot of people to invest in women football. Of course, in the past, we've seen Dr. Lawrence Mlindwa invest, but we don't know why the team no longer operates. It would feel good, Otai, if we had a Vipers football club.
Yeah.
Okay. As we look at Nakayondo save this.
I like what you're saying.
Yeah.
KCC football. Yeah. KCC should have a women's club.
Yeah.
I think Vipers should have.
Yeah, they had one, St. Mary's, and I don't know what happened.
URA should have.
Definitely. You know why I say this? Claire Mlindwa is on Twitter tweeting about everything in this game. So you'd love to see some of that being talked about.
The most interesting thing is some of the teams that are playing here are actually school teams. This is the earlier chance that almost the goalkeeper of Mela had given away. Most of these teams are from school. We have seen that.
Yeah.
From school.
Yes.
And
those that don't have schools at least have partnered with the schools within the vicinity.
So I don't know which excuse that... the Vipers. I don't know it,
but I'm not going to it.
The Chansey, she's offside. Well, why don't you share with the listener and viewer, really?
Oh, let them wait for Black Thursday on Star FM. Well, it is 1-0. Ajax Queens, Margaret Naluvega, having scored that in the 9th minute. Vision FC have not yet replied, but are trying to probe a little better, are trying to have a better game approach. But I think there was good homework done by Ajax Queens. Apparently, there is a way they are trying to limit on the speed used by Vision FC. They do not allow them to get them on the break and are trying to cover all the spaces that Vision used yesterday to beat St. Peter's.
Well, Vision Women's Football Club all the way from Kitgumia, currently trailing by 1-0. Oyela has been reduced to a defender right now. Poor clearance from Namakula. Unaway, but repossessed. And then Nagozi just cannot get that ball away. Good play there from Akiror, but repossessed here. Arach. Away by Namukirwa. Chested down perfectly by Namuonge, but the pressure still on. It's away by Akulu. And the referee doesn't want them with a free kick here for Vision. They seem to be getting their Vision on right now. And the Vision is maybe try and get an equalizing goal here. Among in Penina, back in action for the women of Kitgum. Well, trust me, I think the members of parliament will be very happy with this. Trying to see the ladies from their side playing.
Yeah.
Kitgum. Yeah. Kitgum has a cabinet minister, I think.
I remember Kitgum. I remember Honorable Beatrice Anyua.
Yeah, Anyua, yes.
To that.
Mama Mabida.
Yes.
Yeah.
I remember her connected to Kitgum. If my politics serves me today.
Offside, goal scorer, Nalubega.
Yeah, as long as there is no card and warning issued for offside, they can try to venture forward. And if at an instance they are gotten onside, then Vision, a football club, have to worry because it looks like Ajax Queens have improved defensively and offensively too.
It's a long ball forward and just goes away for a goal kick. Well, if you look at the Elite League, I think I've not seen a team from West Nile region in the Elite League.
And the
Elite League. From the West Nile.
So just think about the teams that started King of Kings, Dynamic, Punyaruguru. We had Rinez, that is Wakiso.
West Nile not yet represented in
Let's
the Elite.
Let's wait for the last group. West Nile.
Yeah, Arua, Koboko, Yumbe, Zombo.
Okay.
Because at least we have seen St. Peter's comes from Apache. Then you have Vision from Kitgum.
And Amuria.
Then you have Amuria, that's from, of course, Teso region.
Kataka.
Group D, Kataka Zimbali. So Group D actually has more interesting teams there. I think we shall see teams from Acholi also represent. Ooh, that's a miscue there by the captain. Namuonge driving through and well timed there from Anina Lucky.
Yeah, Anina Lucky is helping out a lot. It is twice that she has served the team, whereas they had to defend on the break.
So goes for the offside. So it will be Frekikia to the Vision side. Frekikia. Oyela. Wondering what she's doing defending Oyela.
I think there was Oyela. Oh, I thought it
she's
was
the captain, Oyela.
Yeah.
She was striking yesterday, and she began as a striker today. Trying to look for Nachanzi. Ball is a little bit low.
Prayers are always answered. Peter Otai.
Yes.
Claire says she will initiate talks with the father, and soon we'll have a women team for the Venoms.
Like I said,
just see.
There is no reason. There's no actual reason.
Yeah.
That Vipers doesn't have a women's team. No reason. You
just
can't
see the magic commentary can bring. Actually, if that team comes back, I'll be glad to tweet that me and Peter did initiate the idea. Thank you, Claire, for response, and thank you for watching. Thank everybody there at Kitende watching this game, and the people in Kitugum, likely the people in Buyelenga, definitely, because they have to follow what their girls are doing. Now an attack from Vision is imminent.
A team gift. Now ball just goes away to Nakayondo. It's away by Pamela. Trying to look for Nachanzi. Nachanzi doing well. Backtrack perfectly here by Vision Women FC. Anena. Oh, that ball is actually not going away. Sun coming out in Njeru right now. And that's the lady herself, Ngozi Maureen. Well, they really, KCC, URA, these are teams that really should be having women, a woman football
yeah,
team.
Yeah, more so for those that already have the financial muscle. Financial muscle, sorry. Peter, what is... Jesus Christ. Anyhow, all those that have the funds at their disposal, they need to just go for that, like you said. More so, the organization and the authorities, when you talk about URA, KCC, when you talk about UPDF.
Yeah, UPDF, that's another. There's no reason. Benedette, dodges one, corner. There is no reason you can give me for UPDF not having a women's soccer club. Maroons do have. They are playing tomorrow.
Yes.
I won't buy any idea if you know that you'll give me that they don't have money or they don't have the ladies. That's no idea, really. Kuna. Here for the Ajax, brought in by Akiror. It's deep. Brushed away.
It is half an hour played so far. And Ajax Queens have proved their worth. Are trying to venture forward, taking their chances, and actually asking a lot of questions. Vision Group are yet to react and answer.
Oh, could be going out for corner. And again, good defending from Lucky Anena. That won't be very happy there, but they are trailing by 1-0. Yesterday they were leading by 4-0. Now they're trailing by one.
Okay, after tomorrow, I think could be rest. Tomorrow could be resting day. Then Sunday, the last matches in the group. Let's get in this corner from Nangozi.
Corner from Nangozi. We still have possession. It was Amongin. Now Oyela. And away there by Nakayonjo. Well, Vision have actually put a lot of pressure. The Ajax Queens have put a lot of pressure there on Vision.
Yeah, I think they are better today, and that's the Ajax Queens are known to people. The one that played yesterday in the first half was a bit shaky. Group D comprises of Lango Queens. Probably this could answer your questions.
Lango, that's from Lango, Lira.
Yeah. Echo, women football team, Shimaroons and Wakiso Hills.
You see? So there is no team from West Nile in the Elite League. The ladies or the people governing the game in West Nile to work hard.
And then we should recommend the likes of Wando Paraka, Arua Hills, Paida to start up one.
Chance up front now, Nalubega. Offside. Free kick now here. It's away by Adong Chen. Collected very well by Akiror.
Actually, when you talk about the top clubs having women teams, I hear you, Peter. In Tanzania, the crown champion,
Simba
Queens, a female side of the followed Simba FC Football Club. I want to research them about Vihinga that won in Kenya, and those are going to battle it out with Lady Dubs that won the top tier league in Uganda. But apparently I can get a reflection of what you're talking about. Defending at the back, it is very poor, and keeper has to come to duty. Definitely she does that and saves the day for Vision Football Club.
Should be noted that Uganda is basically the one leading the race when it comes down to women football development, because we are the only only association in SEKAFA that actually has two parallel leagues running. The Elite together with, of course, the Super. Most of the other countries do have just the top tier, the Kenyans and, of course, the Tanzanians. But now we have the Elite, then you have the Super League. And these ladies are fighting for a trophy and also promotion to the Super League. And bragging rights, anyway. Arach failing to be herself today.
Yeah, the bragging rights were in Kampala at first. I went to Mokono, and now the people in Masindi have them, because Lady Doves are champions, and Fazila did make sure of that.
Oh, two balls on the pitch.
A drop ball, she goes for Lady Aisha.
Anena Oyela try to strike. Oh, that was going in. Oh, very, very, very unlucky there, you have to admit, for
but
Oyela Farida.
Defending, Peter. The header to keep the ball away from the right direction saved Ajax Queens.
Somebody's head was almost removed. That's good control away by Amongin. The flag goes up for the offside. Today, a team gift there has been a shadow of herself. If you're to compare their team of yesterday and a team of today, together with Atimango, who has actually now drifted from the wing to the center, jersey number 11.
Yeah, I think the right back and left back in Akirola, Nakayon, Josharon, have done better today than they did yesterday to keep them at bay. Poor communication could have gotten them into problems. Apparently, the keeper and defender could not call out for whose ball it was.
Well, Nalubega's goal is the one separating the two sides, Vision and Ajax. Currently, it's Ajax having the Vision here. Throw in. Away by Nakayonjo. Nakayonjo again towards the byline. Fighting, ball possessed. It's given away. Nakayonjo. Gifts a Vision with a free kick. Began quickly by Aneno, who gives it away cheaply yet again. Just failing to cool down, really. Akirori, that header. Collected by Nalubega. Booted away. Here comes Arach. Atimango stolen away back to the captain Oyela Farida, who has actually come now to striking from the right back. Arach. Atimango. Arach again. Atimango, that's good football. She tries to repass that ball, forced to the center, and there's a free kick here to the Vision. Could be the captain having a little bit of a knock there, Oyela Farida. Free kick. Well, the Queens from Bulenga up against the Visionaries all the way from Kitgum. Was the foul. Oh, that's painful. You can actually see that from Oyela herself.
Yeah.
So this is Penina Amongin. Will be the one to try and see if you can get the top corner of the goal, try to beat Nakayondo.
Referee instructing the wall to do better.
It's Pamela up against Amongin.
Referee still busy. We'll give her the instruction to take it later, but now to take some pressure off her. Oyela comes in.
This is Among in. Very unlucky. Not a very bad idea. Trying to go for the other side of the post there.
Yeah, where the keeper wasn't standing. But it was just a little too much and it eluded the keeper going the other way.
And Neno. Among in. Neno. Trying to drive that ball through. Look at this for football. It's dropping, but over the bar. And it's a corner.
Yeah, Vision have tried to react. The keeper is always there to save Ajax Queens. But they have also not been clinic enough. Because from about 4 or 5 chances, they have failed to get it right in front of goal. They can't do better with this corner coming.
It's a corner to be delivered forward. That's a big corner. Away by the goalkeeper, Pamela. Oyela. Left leg hook. And put it away there by Namakula. Well, trust me, when Vision settle in the game, they are very, very stubborn side. Full of pace and creativity. Love to pass that ball through. But also, I have to add the other part. They are wasteful.
Yeah, they have been wasteful. Not been a prolific today in front of goal. They need to be a little astute to earn that equalizer with 6 minutes left of the normal time.
Offside again, that's Arach. Oh, got nothing there this time, Arach. Thirty-nine minutes of this Elite Fufal Women League. Oyela. Oyela again. Collected by Mwonge.
She's also been silent today.
Good running from Nalubega. Margaret now. A chance is inside requesting. Margaret crosses. And defended by Asiro Recho. Sometimes these early morning games are very difficult to deal with. But they are enjoying themselves. That's the coach of the Ajax Queens today. Atimango. Oh, this could be nice. Flag remains down. Raj beaten. Very good backtracking there from the Ajax Queens. So Raj totally failing to keep her body on check and fouls in the process. Just number 10 there, Raj. Well, flag remained down. But again, very good work from Nakayongo.
Yeah,
Nakayongo rather.
Yeah, she's been a tremendous, at her position, always running back to help out cover positions where defenders have gone up front.
On the run in, Atimango on the right, up against Akiror. It's 11 versus 11. And Akiror does very well. Atimango recollects the ball, but she gets a throw in.
In the stands could be players of different teams.
Yeah, the next game coming up, that is
Between St. Peter's and Amuria High School. St. Peter's need to win. Amuria won yesterday narrowly, 3-2. Had given up their lead in the second half where Ajax Queens came back from 2 goals down. And if they win today's game, then a lot of weight in terms of pressure will be taken off them for some time. Ajax Queens advancing.
It's a big ball forward. And the referee shall award a free kick here. 3 minutes to play for. No more time. Just only 3 minutes to play. It's Vision 0, Ajax 1.
We didn't have a water break today.
It's a morning clash. So I think the water break comes in the second half. Midday. Yeah.
Okay. Midday. A free kick for Vision Football Club. How they deliver will be key if they are to get that equalizer.
Arach trying to chase. I don't think if she can keep that ball and play really.
Yeah, she was fast, but the ball was faster. And I think she started a little bit too late when the pass had already been released. Of course, the coach complaining about something, wondering why she did not read the game well to see where the ball was coming from.
Well, just reminding you that next week it will be the Stanbic Uganda Cup again coming through. So basically we have been a beehive of activity when it comes down to Ugandan football, really.
Vipers Villa is on Monday.
Oh, that's a good one.
Yeah, so
sweet
Claire.
One.
Prepare yourself for that one.
There will always be a statement that will be in my head for a long time.
Yeah,
between Vipers and Villa, but we shall talk that. This is a rush.
Vipers have beaten Villa home and away already in the season. So beating them again in the cup will be sweet for the diehards of Vipers, most especially Lawrence Mulindo, who has a bone to pick with them after what happened with the stadium. A lot has happened in Ugandan football, but it's all good as long as it takes us somewhere. I just think it's okay. Corner for Vision Football Club.
And this will be brought in by Fiona Arach. Long ball forward. Gotten away, but not very far. Intercepted and cleared away from the mix again. Nicking ball. Giving away. There's nobody to follow up on that. And Timango, together with Arach, I think we're the ones offside. And, currently it's Nakayondo enjoying her time here with that headgear.
Nakayondo should be so special. Pamela, I know.
That's a big clearance.
Yeah, I love her ball distribution skills.
There's a chance, but unfortunately Arach is offside. Well, some of these footballers are senior 2, senior 3. So they have a bright future.
Yeah, it's a good foundation because you believe when somebody's in senior 2, those about 4 more years of good football, because most of them leave the school after doing USC exams. And the referee signals for half time.
Well, it's been, an interesting first 45 minutes, but belonging to the Ajax Queens. Well, they are the ones that are leading this encounter by 1-0 over a side that scored 4 goals in first half yesterday. I think the coach has a lot to do when it comes down to talking to his girls. That is, the coach over the Vision side has a lot to do. But meanwhile, for the Queens, the Ajax Queens, I think the coach will be very impressed with the performance of the side today. But let's wait and see, because the next 45 will be very, very key for Vision and for Ajax here. Very, very instrumental and very key here. So just waiting to see if who's will be panning up here tonight. It's Vision and Ajax, as the two will be trying very much to come into possession. So we're going in for a quick break. When we come from the break, it will be the analysis. Then from there, the second half, we'll be moving on here tonight. One-on-one here. So that's how it stands. Go for the break now, and we come back with more after this.
What does it mean to be closer together? It's taking the last bus home for a surprise visit. Closer together is strangers finding a connection. It's bringing home something much more than a box. It's the warmth of home, or the beginning of something new. There's magic in sharing the things that we love, because it's those things that bring us close together. Introducing Cleveland Hill Day and Boarding Primary School, located in Chiwando, Chisalusalu, along Bukoto Roundabout, 2 kilometers from Kalere at the Northern Bypass, on your way to Chisasi. This is a world-class standard school with the most qualified teachers that will turn your child into a world changer. We have a fully stocked library, a balanced diet for the children, a calm environment suitable for learning, and pocket-friendly school fees. Registration for P1 to P6 is ongoing, and second term is starting on 6th April 2021. Call us on 0774-950-277 or 0705-861-262 for more information. Cleveland Hill Day and Boarding Primary School. The Lord is my shepherd.
Cha COVID-19 chijja kugwa. If we get vaccinated now, observe social distancing, wear masks properly, sanitize or wash our hands with soap and water regularly. Together we can defeat this enemy.
Margaret Nalubega strike in the first half brings us back at halftime. 1 Ajax Queens and 0 Vision Women Football Club. Good morning, Ugandans. Welcome back to the FUFA Women Elite League studio down here at UBC. It's John Burns Sentamu here, and I'm joined by Fifi Rampiki Namiro. But a little reminder to all Ugandans, it's football we bring to you, and it's the FUFA Women Elite League. The FUFA Women Elite League, despite the elite in it, is the second tier of Ugandan football. I work under a very strict producer, but I know he's going to allow me to do this. One of our very own, Engineer Tamale Jimmy, is graduating today at Makere University with a bachelor's degree in telecommunications engineering. Congratulations, Engineer Jimmy Tamale. The beauty of life is the simplicity, and this man is so simple. Fifi, you've not worked with him for a while, but you know him for his simplicity. Please.
I really enjoy his chai. He sometimes tries and says, Fifi, I see you. Sometimes, you know, probably the commentary is stretching you. He gets in a cup of tea. Sometimes the water. Engineer Tamale, I congratulate you. I congratulate you, and I know you'll be useful to the nation.
Yeah, producer Eddie Mwesi will excuse us for that. There's no way Engineer Tamale is going to graduate, and we leave it at that. You've got to praise your own. Engineer Tamale, we wish you all the best in life. I know the future is yours, in your hands. Fifi, football.
Yeah, the football, talking about it, I think there is a great homework done by the assistant coach that is for Ajax Queens. Apparently, the issues they had yesterday may be acclimatizing to the artificial turf, settling in soil, and probably Amoria were a more fast team. And then they watched the game between St. Peter's and Vision Football Club, because they have worked on the areas where Vision were strong yesterday. Vision were strong on the break. They had a very good midfield today. They have tried to neutralize it because they have come in a little bit more compact, and just one switch of a player saved the day. That is taking Akirola away from the midfield, putting her at left back, sometimes even roving, coming in up front and helping out with the back too. For me, I think that has done so well for them. That is why they have a goal, because when you look at the top players, like we did mention, that is Amongin for you, Arach, Farid herself, Oyela today.
At Mango.
Yeah, at Mango. Mango.
Sharifa.
Yeah, Sharifa. Today they have not been on their best. Whenever they try to move, there is a player trying to mark them. They are rounding them off at the right time, closing down the spaces, and apparently that has paid off. But again, also, when you talk about vision, they have wasted a lot of chances. They have not been clinical in front of goal. They have faced one of the best goalkeepers in the division, lightly, because for me, putting a keeper who is sick, like you've seen, there is evidence she's sick from yesterday, but they are telling her, as long as the doctor passes, that you can go into the game, she is there. She's the old Nakayongo, that is Pamela, has stopped about four dangerous attacks, threats at goal, and doing well for them. I think for me, that is where Ajax Queens have become a threat and are doing well. Can they earn the 3 points? The question will be answered in the next 45 minutes.
Yeah, but the goalkeeping, you talked about the goalkeeping, and all guys that have come to UBC, including me, yeah, talked about the goalkeeping at this tournament, and we saw poor goalkeeping, surely, by the vision goalkeeper,
yeah,
Fifi.
Yeah.
This needs to be addressed once and for all. Otherwise, yeah, goalkeeping is terrible. Can we attribute it to the official staff that she miscalculated?
No, she couldn't get there on time? No. But Najemba, okay, we saw Najemba, she was good earlier on. But today, I think Nakayongo is also playing on the same turf. So if she's getting something right, stretching, flexing, for me, there are some easy things that I think, no, we will not blame it on the artificial turf. I will not take that. Burns, it is a low shot. It doesn't have a lot of energy on it. Mm-hmm. It is coming your way. You have about four defenders. Even the fifth comes in to try help. Of course, the backside has failed. But you're standing where the ball is coming. For me, it is poor game reading because most of our goalkeepers depend on reading where the ball is and the feet of the opponent, how they are going to shoot. They anticipate. That is how sometimes some of them grab the penalty balls coming in. But then this one came. She was standing there. And for me, I think I cannot say she intended, but somehow slept on the job for about 2 seconds she missed. And that is when she got the ball inside the back of the net, because probably she thought it was still on, but the timing was very wrong. For me, it is clumsy and obnoxious.
Fifi, you're cramming your English here. I want to splash your English out to the Ugandans. Clumsy and obnoxious. Anyway, Ugandans out there, I know I've understood what Fifi's talking about. It's clumsy, careless, I mean, and obnoxious and rarely seen. I think it's what she meant to you Ugandans out there. But anyways, the football continues, and we promise Ugandans that we shall bring you sport, and sport we are bringing you is the Four Women Elite League. We remind you that we shall come up again with the Uganda Cup a little later, but women's football is what we talk now. Fifi,
yeah,
what can Vision do? Because they need, if they get a point off this,
yeah,
then they put themselves in good stead.
Yeah,
but if they lose
position,
this game, then it's going to be trouble for them. What can they do second half to ensure they come back against a team that has been around almost forever, is so hyped,
yeah,
and this result, I know, is echoing well amongst many sitting rooms or offices in Uganda.
I think you have Anena in the midfield. They have Anena and Anene. One is in defense, one is in the midfield. Yesterday they were a little bit more mobile. First of all, try to...
Look at that goal.
The goal, like I said, I use the right words. I want to go back to it, but
clumsy,
the goal is
obnoxious.
Yeah, obnoxious. For me, the goalkeeper is not serious at all in that incident.
Yeah.
Of course, not the whole minutes, because she may come and save us something. Just look at it. But just look at the defenders. You are three. You fell to round off the player. Passes past. There is an advance one. Keeper.
Okay. Yeah. She had reached. She traveled a lot,
yeah,
because she was almost on the other.
Yeah, side.
Post the end, and then she had to come up.
Bands.
The reflexes. We've talked about this with you before.
Yeah.
That most of these goalkeepers don't have ample training. They're training under coaches that only talk about the forwards, defenders, and midfielders. So they don't get enough training to do those reflexes. It's about reflexes. You're close to Onyango. Ask him. Reflexing. Jump from
Jesus
his end
Christ.
To go the other end.
Did you have
He's
to
your
say
friend,
that?
Isn't he?
Did
as
you
a
have
journalist.
To mention that?
So I think I can't blame him that much at times, but I blame the entire setup of lack of goalkeeper coaches. Let's go ahead with the bill.
Yeah, Jeff, like you said, what could they do? I think they are they are more peaceful than Ajax Queens. They could use that. Then they need Anene to improve in the midfield, because today those passes that came in yesterday, the quick ones, opening up spaces, because we did see that Ajax Queens has not been tested in the first half of the game, the 45 minutes. Yesterday at the back, they were very porous. They were living on tension. They failed to concentrate. And today, because you've not tried, you may not know what they really did prepare today.
Okay.
So for me, add more pace into it, consistently attack, and then because they've gotten better chances at goal than Ajax Queens, convert those chances. Once in a while, concentrate. We've seen keepers, we've seen the keeper herself, Nakayongo. We've seen her sometimes also, yesterday, the goal she conceded, when the defense failed, sometimes she also cannot hold any longer. You realize when she was beaten by Amuria in the last minutes as they tried to come back in the second half, that sometimes, like even if she's very good, she could also have her challenges. So today, he capitalized on those. We've seen the blockbusters go in. You have players with big muscles. They can shoot. They have gotten the set pieces, and actually they are fouling a lot. So minimize on fouling in dangerous areas to your opponents, and then use your pace and try to capitalize. Go for the set pieces if they can go in, because at the moment all you need are goals. Get them in and settle.
Please, Uganda, keep watching UBC, because women's football is up and running by the Federation of Uganda Football Associations. We've got the under-17s, I remind you, preparing for a World Cup. We've got the under-20s preparing for a World Cup. We've got the women's senior team preparing to represent Uganda at the AFCON, Women AFCON, that will happen in Morocco next year, and all the World Cups are also next year. So if you watch keenly, you will have judgment and not speak from a very uninformed position when the teams are selected for the various national teams. Fifi, Ajax Queens, a darling to many Ugandans, must ensure they hold on to this, or even better, to stand any chance of qualifying.
Yeah, considering what they where they come from. When you come from Bulenga, it's a busy road. It's metropolitan, of course. When it's you have a place, it's a highway, en route to Kampala. They have things there that attract very much. What do they have to do? For me, all they have to do is concentrate, try to go for a second goal cautiously, because you're playing a team that has players who are faster than your players. So what you do is play cautiously, minimize on the mistakes, so that you're not given the yellow cards. Then we've seen it that probably the keeper has not been alert, but now take advantage of the defense, who sometimes are concentrating on going forward to look for the equalizer. Capitalize on that and try to come back. I believe if Ajax Queen go for a second goal, then try to defend amicably, because the best way of defending is attacking. But attack cautiously, and then they can try to get the 3 points. But it's I think there are more minutes to be played for, and I think they need to do better, because vision I seem threatening at the moment.
Vision what? Don't mention what you said. Okay, let's go into the second half. We're a bit of time, and Fifi Obi in the middle will give you the commentary. We see you at the end of the 90, but don't forget, another game will come up later today at midday kickoff. It's going to be Amuria against St. Peter's. Amuria won the first game. They'll look for victory in the second game. See you at the end of 90 of this.
Player that actually brought her down there. So free kick, and free kick shall be sent forward by Akirol Patricia Amongi. Patricia at the midfield level, they're still looking for the options, and easily given away. Raj can't control that ball here for the Visionaries now. It's a long ball through, good control yet again by Amongin. Kulu, Nachanzi, Kuna. Well, you have to admit that today the Vision Women Football Club, all the way from Kitgum, has actually failed to relax in its game.
Yeah, and that's what they need. to take chances. Ajax Queens have a corner, and if they can capitalize on that, probably they can go in for a second.
Ngozi will be the one to deliver this from the corner, which she does. It's away by the captain, Oyela. Ngozi yet again for the ladies. Away by Oyela. Rachia. It's away by the captain. Big clearance from Namukerwa Dorin. Oyela. Well, sometimes they actually do play their game slightly slow. The Vision Queens. Sorry, the Vision Women Football Club. Anina. More pressing needs here from the Ajax Queens now, looking for Nachanzi. Nachanzi away to the goal scorer, Nalubega Margaret now.
Yeah, there is a little bit of some integration by Ajax Queens. You can see transition of the ball from one department to another. Apparently, if you have Nachanzi, who is attacking on the right side, trying to hold the ball and invite the midfielders to come and keep it, for me, it is a very good tactic, because when you have the ball, then you have a lot of things to use it for.
Away from danger, Aki Roar now, trying to utilize her space there.
Yeah, it was too big. She kept it a little bit too big.
Aki Roar there, student of Kulu University, first year. And also been in the area of women football. There's a lot of experience there, Kiror. Oh, that was some weird orthodox piece of control from a team gift a while ago. Now that ball was actually rolling, so Neno has to send it back slightly behind and restart this. Rachel Asiro leaves it to Among in Penina. Nalin Kuma. Nalin Kuma. Here by Namonge. Namonge again. Fighting away through Nalin Kuma to the rescue. One pass through, looking for possession. Nangozi. Away from Namakula. Ooh, it's bouncing, but to the goalkeeper, Loom.
Yeah,
well, sometimes when it bounces right in front of the goalkeeper, yeah, you have to be worried.
Yeah, sometimes the bounce, if it's too heavy, then sometimes it goes past the goalkeeper, defending on the height.
Oh, yeah, they come again. Could be a penalty. Looks like the referee's whistles up, but it goes for the offside here.
Okay, offside happened before the infringement. And referee walks to the player to see if she's in a fine state.
Now she's fine to continue this one. Could be the goal scorer, Nalubega. Lot of pain there.
Yeah. Drowning in pain. Okay.
Oof, she landed awkwardly.
Yeah, and looked like had control with the arm.
Namonge. Looking for Nalubega. Ooh, goalkeeper! That's very awkward goalkeeping, really. Very
Jesus.
Lucky.
Yeah, too many mistakes at the back for her. But lucky this one passes off. They can now breathe and try to build from their own half.
Akulu. Away by Akiror. Well, they're playing very well today, the Ajax Queens. Different game they have today. Namwonge. This is Namwonge. Well, it takes a long time, by the way, to think about either passing that ball or putting it in. Oyela Farida. Oyela beats one. Picks up a free kick. Well, she's a very fine player, Oyela. Very, very fine footballer. But today, things not going her way. Oyela, the captain of Vision Queens. It's free kick. Long from Oyela. Direction, I don't know. Oh, that's very disappointing, really. Oh, very disappointing. But again, she's a clever footballer.
Ajax Queens have really shaped up. They are really composed. Apparently, they managed to get a few passes amongst themselves, something that we hadn't seen in the game since a start. Well, substitution for a vision group. A coach feels they are not giving him what he's supposed to be given. So very quickly, and referee orders for restart immediately. Attacking Namwenge with the ball. Oh, she misses herself. Unlucky.
Well, there was a quick substitution. A team gift substituted.
Yeah, a team is not their team. Who was evergreen yesterday, brilliant, making those runs today. Her contribution has been limited, and apparently the coach thought it wiser to replace her for the remaining minutes. So that means that they will change information, because her team was apparently helping out to fill space between the midfield and striking line.
Well, she was replaced by Abel Priska. Let's see if we can actually change some bit of flow in this match. Patricia. Foul. Oyela was on that foul this time. So it will be a free kick now to the Ajax Queens. And Abel there coming in for a team. Confirmation of that sub for the Vision Queens all the way from Kitgum. Away by Akiro, intercepted by Oyela. Now Atimango loses possession. Nakayongo, Nachanzi, looking for Nangozi. Oh, that's going to be a free kick right in front of the referee. It's poor play there from Aneno. It's going very hard on Nangozi Maureen.
She's also been a shadow of herself. The Anenwe yesterday was more vibrant and more mobile than she is today. She actually linked the midfield yesterday to the strikers. That is why they scored very many goals, 5 in total to be exact. And today, as she was dribbled past, if you don't get the ball, you go for the leg, and that's what she did.
Namwonge for this one is cutting through. The goal goes over the bar. Marwan got me very confused, just like yesterday. She's good at that.
Yeah.
Yeah, she scored a goal just like that
in
yesterday.
The same fashion.
Yes. Almost got me confused today. Certainly got me confused. Yeah, they come again, piling the pressure. Ngozi, forward ball. Swept away by Oyela. She's an all-rounder, you can see. She's almost in every possession.
Yeah, she has gone for a free roll, trying to correct mistakes when a certain department makes many of them. Again, just a few inches above. Namwenge tried to get the ball on target.
Kiror. Straight to the goalkeeper, Alum needs to send this ball in very quickly. That's long. Oyela. Dropping that ball forward now. Here comes the attack now. Timango brings it back and... Well, nobody just nicking that ball through, but the flag is up for the offside. And it's... the new entrant in Abel Priska, who has actually got napping there, came as a replacement of our team gift. So it will be a free kick now to the Africa, to the Ajax Queens. Mugirwa away, Oyela with the control. Here they come again, Abel. Mugirwa. Nachanzi fouling. Free kick to Vision. Samba So free kick now to be delivered here by the captain, Farida Oyela. I'm fancying she'll be going for goal here, Patricia.
The distance is a bit far.
There she goes, Patricia. It's dropping through to the goalkeeper.
Yeah,
Kayondo.
Yeah, now Kayonga has been one of those that are brilliant, keeping her line. Keeper should get this first before anybody.
No foul. Flick through. Farida Uyela now. Here come the Queens. Sorry, the Visionaries. No foul. And Arach was the last player to hit that ball through. Well, she needs to begin doing that a lot, Uyela Farida.
Yeah, and you love the interception coming in from Ajax Queens. Because if they had let her free, then she had all this shooting space. When she does what she does, to keep her at bay, intercept when you have the time. And that's what they did.
Mung in fouled. Free kick here. Could have been a free kick. The referee whipped play on.
Good skills from the captain. Oyela Farida.
Oh, call for the handball. Nothing awarded. Aber loses the ball to Nalukuma.
Yeah, Nalukuma does well for me the turn.
Away from Alum, the goalkeeper. Yela. Arach. Now stolen away by Nalukuma. Atimango with possession. Very pacey player. She goes down and could be a bookable offense.
Yeah, yellow card should be issued by Lady Aisha. The
yeah, giving away to Nasali Juanita there.
Yeah.
Oh, she's complaining there, Nasali. Again, she's a very pacey player, Atimango.
Yes,
Salifa.
Timed the ball, missed the ball and went for the leg. Nasali for you. A free kick. Vision Football Club is probing.
Kick. Farida Uyela will be the one to go slightly long with this. It's Group C, second match of the group. Ajax Queens losing the first one. Vision winning the first one. Well, looks like Farida Oyela will be the one trying to make this ball through over the bar. Had a bad idea to go for goal, but a lot of power on that from the captain herself, Oyela Farida. Almost approaching the hour mark of the game. Oyela. Oh, Rach is way offside.
She actually slept there. Whatever she was planning, I don't know. Because even when you want to get offside, sometimes they keep nearer to the defender. She was way off. And Ajax Queens can now breathe. A free kick from the backside.
Nachanzi now. This is Nachanzi inside the D. Nachanzi. But the goalkeeper, Lou Myrin, wasn't disturbed with that ball, really. A bear loses. Exactly what
yellow
that was
card.
About.
And that is a yellow card for me. Intentionally did it.
That is a Kulu Sharon. I don't know what was going on in her mind, Akulu. She even smiles it off.
Probably she thought that her teammate would be brought down and it was a free kick for their side. The way she handled it, takes the yellow card calmly.
Long from Akiror. And put down again. Nalubega. Ngozi dropping ball forward. Flag remains down, but now it's up. Mwonge fighting very hard to get something for this game. Here comes Oyela. Away by Doreen Namugirwa. Well, Oyela has actually been very, very busy defending, striking.
Yeah.
Oh, that was the handball.
She was also complaining about a certain handball. And then she was gotten there. Culprit. Referee was there. And she didn't have to say anything. Now has to play more cautiously. Otherwise, a second booking means a send-off. And her team playing a shot of one player.
Referee does blow the whistle. I think
there is substitution to be made.
No, she's having a word with the assistant. I don't know what for.
What happened?
She's confirming this.
When the...
Oh, she wants a word here. She wants a word.
Yeah. It looked like the referee had gotten inside the assistant. And when they do, it means there is a problem.
Yeah, that is Aneno being warned by the center referee.
Yeah.
Exactly what's going on there, but
Aneno could have said something.
It's an earlier yellow card given out to the handballer or the goalkeeper
in the middle in of the play. Pitch.
Yeah, Kulu Sharon. It's just 27 minutes remaining to play for here. Vision nil. Ajax wins one. In the D and stolen away this time by Amongin. Now Oyela driving through. Abel is running forward. Unfortunately, Abel.
Yeah, Abel came in for gift and has improved with pace on the right side. They were a little bit draggy when gift was still in.
Okay,
and they need to use their pace, which is one of their best strengths. To create the so bad needed goal. Two against one, keeper comes into play, clears away from danger, and lucky the ball lands on a teammate's leg.
Here comes good player Nalu Kuma.
Again, keeper has to come to help. So many loose balls at the backside, a lot of blind passes. In the midfield, Caroline Nachanzi.
They're down, game continues. Ngozi driving forward to Nakayongjo. Just gonna be gotten.
Yeah, Nanyongjo came in a little bit too late. The pass was already heavy. As assistant official, has to call back the three into her side.
Okay,
Kayonjo, away by Anena, collected here by Oyela. Oyela again, quick legs there for Oyela. Watch 25 minutes remaining to go. Oyela doesn't look comfortable here. I'm thinking for Yela can't continue. That injury seems to be bothering her now. Nachanzi.
She had forgotten the ball.
It's good play there from Nakayonjo Sharon, trying to hold that midfield well.
Ajax Queens in the midfield, Peter, paying attention to all details, meeting the balls halfway before they reach destination from their opponents, I think for me, is working, but one goal not enough to give them better leverage. They need to push and add another goal Otherwise, when Vision are lucky, then Ajax may go back to square one.
Oyela. Kiron. This way. Among it. The bear just failing to keep the ball on play.
Mwange looks a little tired. You'd think it's about time the coach withdrew her for fresh legs.
Irina Luma has already conceded a goal from that lady who has sent that ball through Nalubega. Nachanzi trying to play hard. And she wins a throw in here for the Queens. Well, maybe now we could be having that substitution. But no. Referee says it's the other way around. The Visions thought it was a ball for the Queens. Now it's the ball for the Queens. Sharon. Long ball forward. It's more pressing now here. That's Atimango. Fouled in the process, Atimango. Free kick here for the Vision side as they continue to probe up. The referee wants Oyela to take the ball behind. Away by Oyela. Ngozi. Nachanzi. Patricia Akiror here. Very pacey footballer, Patricia. Hits all of this. Tries to nick it through. Ooh. And Namwonge was offside by the time the ball went through.
Yeah, for me, she looks a little too tired and not being helpful. She's not complimenting them at all. And that is a gap up front that the coach needs to critically look at and analyze. Oh, Akirol does well.
It's at that right back position for the Vision side. Well, they're here.
About 20 minutes to go. Vision need them better to get the equalizer, but Ajax also need to defend and also add another for the 3 points. And if Ajax Queens win this game, then we are back to square one. That means that we'll have about three teams with 3 points. Of course, not forgetting that the second fixture between St. Peter's and Amoria could change everything.
Here come the Queens now. The goal scorer, Nalubega, doing very well. Now the chess here among in. Sorry, Atimango. And Nakayondo doing very well to come to the rescue here for the Queens. She's totally not giving away anything for fate.
Namwenge chasing.
Oyela. Mongin, Oyela. Nalubega Lom. All bouncing straight up to the goalkeeper, Alum.
Alum goes long. That is almost into the final third. Ball headed away from danger. Ajax Queens, I like the way they have defended in the midfield today.
Stolen off the legs there of Atimango, but they win themselves a throw-in. Just 20 minutes remaining to play for here. 20. Lucky Anena. Trying to look for Atimango. Ball still on play. And Kuma up against the captain Oyela.
A I was about to comment on her, Nalunkuma Martha. She may have failed to get her name on the score sheet, but she's winning those balls from the opponents very well. She has commanded on the left flank for the visiting team so well. Every time there is an opponent, she attacks the opponent without fear and sometimes has managed to get free kicks for Ajax Queens.
There will be a throw in out to Vision. Kiroro was the player that put that ball out for a throw. Throw in here.
The coach is asking Akirol to become opaque so that no ball can go through her, and asks her to calm, do it, don't actually invite any free kicks for the opponents, and that's what Akirol does. Guess the coach is now smiling that instructions are being read so well.
Long forward ball intercepted. Just about 18 minutes of no more time to play for here now. And coming up later will be another entertaining game. St. Peter's up against Amuria. It's a battle of the schools in that one. One from Apache, one from Amuria. Ball forward here. And possessed again, chipping ball forward, but the goalkeeper Irene Alub won't be disturbed here. Oyela. Well, she has been very, very quiet. Nakayondo, no serious chance to save. Ngozi driving forward now, collected here by Namwonge, who does also lose the ball through. Away by Nakayondo, trying to pick up and trying to move on the game slowly by slowly. Get her through Nachanzi. Shot coming up, and that goes out for a goal kick there from Namwonge. Well, Ajax Queens from Bulenga. Still leading this one by 1-0. A few minutes to play for here. Now, Farida Oyela. Now, Nachanzi could actually make them pay. Clumsy defensive football there, but again, repossessed here by the goal scorer, Narubega. One pass, deflects. Corner.
Yeah, corner for Ajax Queens, who have dominated in the midfield. Namwenge going to pick up that ball. I think the coach trusts that she can probably play the next minutes, because as I thought she would be coming off, the coach continues to give her more playing time, and now she has to swing in a corner. She holds up play so well when she has the ball. When she doesn't have it, sometimes she doesn't help out in the chasing. But let's wait and see her delivery.
Long ball forward here. Brush from Nachanzi. Ball goes out.
Caroline tried to meet that very well. Put a lot of energy on it, and apparently it was too heavy. 15 minutes.
Can they keep the ball on play? Yes, they do.
It went outside as she tried to crisscross those legs and get it. Namwenge for you.
Well, earlier on today in the morning, the Minister for Sports, I don't know if he's still the Minister of Sports anyway, that is Honorable Obua Hamson, did lead a team of investors from USA to tour Nombole Stadium this morning.
So when did you hear reshuffle in cabinet? Why are you saying you don't know if he's still the Minister of Sports? Because when the president's sworn in, that means that they cease to be ministers.
Yes,
so who does their work in between now and appointment of new cabinet?
I'll be asking Jagenda about that. He'll be the political guy.
Fred Semakula or Michael Jordan Lokomwa.
Yeah, those are the political guys. Paul Ford now.
She controlled with the arm and was offside. 14 minutes left to be played for. Those are the same minutes that a Vision Football Club have to try go for the equalizer or do better. Captain Farida fails to succeed with a passing to herself and follow up, and it's a throw in up front.
Pull up. Long ball forward now. This is a chance. Straight up to the goalkeeper.
If Safe Hands was a person, it would be Pamela, the custodian for Ajax Queens. Whereas the coach is a little bit silent on the substitutions, I think Namwenge is being kept in the team for the dead ball situations and the corners, because she's delivered each time given the role. And now Akirol will go for this one at the backside. Akirol should be going long. That's what she does across the midfield.
Up front.
There is a chance. Namwenge chases.
I can't get that one.
Reminding you that Group A had King of Kings and Dynamic going through to the quarterfinals. Group B had Arenas Football Club and Bunyaruguru also going through to the quarterfinals. And now Vision.
Long forward ball. Some collision over there. And here they come slowly. Sweeping ball forward away by Among in Penina. Defended well by Namakula.
Namakula keeps the ball away from danger. Should I want the ball near their territory?
Long ball forward. Straight up to the goalkeeper on the other side, Nakayondo.
That cannot give her a problem. She's been astute with that. Always firmly handling the balls and also distributing well. I like this keeper.
Nachanzi. Forward again. Nachanzi fighting. Drives through. That would be a goal kick there.
Caroline Nachans seems outrun from the incident. Farida goes long looking for Atimanga. But again, Ajax do what they have done better. Intercept the balls before reaching destination. And goalkeeper can now take some time off. Yeah, that's what she does. In Nakayong Pamela, they need those seconds off if they are to win with this goal scored by Nalubega earlier on in the first half. Keeper with this one.
Alum.
Alum to captain, who is everywhere.
Chances away. The tempo of the game has actually increased.
Attack. Namwenge holding up play, passing the ball to herself. Does she meet it? Of course, she forces a throw in of Vision football team.
There'll be a throw in here for Vision, and it'll be the lady herself, for Patricia Akiror. Brought in long. Next game is Amuria High School versus St. Peter's. Next game coming up later. Oh, this could be nice again. It's Atimango on the chest line. Like I told you, that's their biggest problem. They are wasteful.
Yeah, they are wasteful, but what I credit also should be given to the defenders of Ajax Queens, Moso Namugera, the captain, who came in to intercept before Atimango could try to unleash a shot. Apparently, when it looks for other teams, you've been seeing that pace could outplay them, but apparently this one hesitated. I think they have reorganized at the backside. The Ajax Queens we saw yesterday in the first half were not as camped as this one, who are trying to minimize. Just look at that. Atimango was already in front. The keeper very alert. But just look at what Namugelwa. They just round her off and give her no space to shoot that ball. For me, good defending coming in from Ajax Queens at the moment. A throw in again for Vision Football Club.
Among it.
Again.
Roar. Okay, free kick out there.
Patricia, 10 minutes. 10. Good 10. That's a man. And how is it? 10. That's a zero. 10. That's a
Okay. The coach is telling his players that they have 10 solid minutes. 10 solid minutes. They shouldn't tire. He's asking them to defend better. Actually, he's telling them to concentrate at the midfield level. And he's asking them to mark more tightly.
Oh. Way by Akiror. Among in Penina. Venturing forward now. Akiror putting a leg on that, but looks like there was an offside, and the lady herself, it was Atimango Sherifa, was offside. Free kick forward by Nasali.
Just hear the coach's words. We have 10 solid minutes. Do whatever you can. Their points actually are on a lifeline.
Another free kick there. Well, Vision's last game will be a battle against Amuria, and for the Ajax Queens, their final game will be against St. Peter's.
Yeah, that is Sunday. If I'm to go with the sequence, two games, then a rest day. That means tomorrow will be a resting day. Okay.
Kept in play. Goalkeeper on the upper line. Atimango. And finally cleared away there by Nachanzi.
Yeah, it was a mistake for the keeper to come out, but they pressed and covered up for her and herself for now, because it looks like Vision will try to throw everything they have.
It's away by Nachanzi. Kept on play there. This is Atimango. And they've given the ball away again for another throw in here to the Ajax Queens, who won't be in a hurry to get this ball forward.
Okay, the reason as to why we've seen very good exploits from goalkeeper of Rennes, that is Najemba, and then this one, Nakayongo, there is a goalkeeping coach, I think in charge of Busiro football team, who is trying to help them here and there. That is why they are a better outfit than most of the keepers we've seen in the Elite League. Red card!
Straight red card given away to number 8, Akulu. Remember,
no, Akulu got a yellow card, yeah. So this is now a second booking and sending off. Too bad for Vision, who are trying to come back in this game. We are okay, but I didn't think she intended on this one. Just look at her, covered in frustrations. Yeah, hope she's not crying. She knows that's now a huge mountain for the team to climb, because apparently they've been a goal down, and now that they are less, then they will be a lot better. Looks like the water break could be coming now. because it is basketball that I know where the players are sometimes are called off for other instructions. Actually, it's called timeout. And now the coaches will use this time to re-energize their players as the goalkeeper is getting medication. Yes, we've talked about this several times from yesterday, Peter, that Nakayongo may not be 100% all right. The collusion yesterday should have left some scalps on her. And apparently she seeks attention every time they get a chance for a break. The coach issuing out instructions to the Vision Queens.
There's a player who has been sent off.
Is there?
Make sure she's not on the bench. Shot 8.
Okay. Oh, isn't confirmation that, from the officials.
Actually, that is your lecturer at Chambogo Football, Chambogo University. After you forget your lecturer's name.
Catherine Adipo.
Yeah, Catherine Adipo. I did hear her voice in the background. Gallant as soldier of football. She's done a lot for football, nurturing the referees and, of course, helping out here and there in terms of a demonstration. Just look at the keeper. You know the way she's saying she's all right? Shaking her head slowly for me. It's a little dangerous. Well, she's lucky tomorrow is a rest day. But apparently, Ajax Queens need to do better in that department. It doesn't mean that if somebody can withstand the situation, then let her go through it. Sometimes they get tired. She doesn't seem very fine, Peter Otai. But it's only 2 minutes left of normal time as the players follow the ball. It was a free kick, I think, for Ajax Queens. That's why we had a red card to Akulu. And we resume from there.
Well, very, very disappointing there for Akulu Sharon. And I don't think the Queens have time to come back in here. And there might be a substitution now happening. There you go. The goal scorer, Nalubega Margaret, is out. And Namirembe is in. Her goal is the one that has actually possibly gifted the Queens this win.
And now Namirembe has to try defend Nalubega's goal in any amicable way through adjusting approach in the midfield and trying to push for a second throw in at the front field.
Pull out, throw in. Well, we're in the 89th minute now. Throw to be brought in very quickly, brushed through. Well, the clearance was not very good. And headed away there by Amongin. Yeah, they come again, the Queens. Oyela looking forward, trying to switch that ball away, looking for a bear. The play there from Patricia Akiror.
They have 5 minutes of added time. Oh, the assistant referee, oh, the fourth official shows 2 minutes of added time. As I was thinking about five because of the stoppages we had, but the referee had a different idea. Vision need to urgently go in for that equalizer.
Mungin is offside. But looks like the referee says Akiror was actually the culprit of the foul, so it will be a free kick here for the Vision Women Football Club from Kitgum. So let's wait and see what comes in from this. Could be the last opportunity there for the Vision Queens, or the Vision Women Football Team rather, to get something from themselves here. 90 minutes clocking. Penina Amongin will be the one looking to deliver this ball forward. Penina. Oh, that's disappointing again from Penina. Lack of concentration, you have to admit. It's just a matter of putting that ball back into the box, not trying to go for goal. We are seconds away from that final whistle. Mwonge away. Nachanzi again. This could be nice. They open up. Ooh, looking for that goal. Not there. Well, she saw the goalkeeper out of her line. Nachanzi. They just failed to take the opportunity. Loom away. Oyela now trying to push that ball forward and disappointing. Timango won't be happy about that. Well, if this remains like this, it means that the Queens will be having 3 points too, and there you have it. The game coming to an end here. The Ajax Queens have beaten the Vision Women Football Club from Kitgum by 1-0. It will be very disappointing for the ladies of Kitgum.
Yeah, very disappointing. They displayed a very good football yesterday, won by a big margin. But today, they have even failed to find the net. Too bad for them. But they still have another match where they can pick those 3 points to make 6 and 6. Enough for you to progress, considering the goal difference you may have picked up along the way.
Well, there you have it. So basically for the Ajax Queens, their final game will be against St. Peter's from Apache. As for the women all the way from Kitgum, that is the Vision Women Football Club, their final game will be a battle against Amuria. And trust me, that won't be a very easy one. For now, we go for the break. Coming back will be the analysis and the wrap-up of this match. Then later on at midday, it will be Amuria up against St. Peter's. Don't go away.
Cha COVID-19 chija kugwa. If we get vaccinated now, observe social distancing, wear masks properly, sanitize or wash our hands with soap and water regularly. Together we can defeat this enemy.
Yeah, that first half goal by Margaret Naruvega wasn't added on in the second half, and it ends a 1-0 for Ajax Queens. They come back into play into this Group C of the Women Elite League. My name is John Burns Sentamu. It's the FUFA Women Elite League studio here at UBC. We promised you sport, and I tell you, and I'll keep emphasizing this, if you hurt, but we shall deliver it the way we promised it to be. And I'm joined in studio by Fefe Pinky Namiro, who is here to break down for us how these games are happening, especially this one that we've just gone through, the 90 minutes of which. Fifi,
will you die when you call me Mama Sky? It's a weekend, and I told
and
you.
I wish you also tell me Mama Sky and Tat and Muchara who. That will see it. That is the ultimatum we set here now. Tell me, yes, I agree. I'll call you Mama Sky and Tata.
And Mchala Watata Sky.
Ah, no. Okay, the football.
Yeah, well, it's 9 minutes of football. And again, Ajax Queens have just made the group dramatic by winning this game 1-0, like you said. Narubega's goal. For me, it's the game approach. And it's a sign of correction of mistakes. Yesterday, in the first half, they looked very, very bad. Actually, they failed to register shots on target. In the first half, only came through the second half to get two goals going. And the second half show yesterday has been brought in today's game and even made better. One particular player for me was Martha Nalunkuma. Today she was given a free role, and her work was to wear down the advancing players of the side from Kitigum. That is Vision Football Group for you. Apparently what she did was
Vision
very good.
What?
Vision Group, Vision Football, Band,
Vision
please.
Football Club.
Yeah, Vision Football Club. Because for me, she was everywhere. I realized, who is this figure? Small in size, but going everywhere, winning the balls, winning the tackles, and going unnoticed. You know, sometimes tackling and the referees always, that means that it could go like Akulu did. Because for Akulu, it was two mistakes, and she got and she was sent off the pitch. Sending off meant that they had to play 3 minutes without her. But already, Ajax Queens looked like they had consolidated the win. For me, they were compact in the midfield. Today, they've not allowed Vision, a football team, to get the balls, because with Vision, when you get them to Amongin, when you get them to Oyela Farida, who has been everywhere, then that would mean problems for you in areas where they would hurt you. I think for me, very good homework done by Ajax Queens. Kudos for them. If they carry on like this in the last game, it means they could go through.
Afifi, every time you work on TV or radio, you've got to know that someone is just tuned in for the first time.
Yes.
Tell Ugandans about how Group C stands as of now.
As Group C stands as of now, we have, yesterday we had a mauling, five goals, and that was by the team beaten Vision Football Club. That means they have 3 points and top the group.
No, they can't top the group, Fifi.
Yeah, because they're
three
goals.
It's head to
head. It is head to head?
Yeah.
Oh,
it's head to head.
But that's 3 points.
That means Ajax is even ahead of them.
Even ahead of them.
Despite the fact that it scored
many
goals.
Before the second match is played, as John Burns puts me to sport, that means that we have Amuria High School leading the group, because apparently so far it has beaten the only team it has played against.
Yeah.
So they are topping the group. Then going by Burns head to head.
Head to head.
Formation.
Ajax is ahead of her.
Ajax is second. Then as you go to Vision Group is third. And apparently St. Peter's, who have not yet picked up a point, are the last in the group, but that can change within an hour.
Yeah, and like Fifi says, within an hour it can change, because Amuria, that beat up on Ajax 3-2 yesterday, plays St. Peter's, that lost to Vision Women's Football Club 5-0.
Why did we opt for head-to-head?
It must be head-to-head. It's the new rule, FIFA.
Everywhere?
FIFA, it's the new rule everywhere. It's head-to-head, then goals against, goals for, goals against. It's head-to-head that comes. The tiebreaker is solved by head-to-head.
I thought it was not African, because no, for us, no, it's goal difference.
Football-ish.
So you're saying it's footballish, it's FIFA-ish.
Yeah, it's FIFA-ish, yeah.
Okay.
And it's the trend, it's the way to go. Head-to-head, you've got to master results. That's why they tell you that in case every team beats up on St. Peter's, for example, they will put out all the results of St. Peter's at some stage and look at the three
and
teams.
The three
how
teams
did you fare against each other?
Critically.
So
okay,
it's FIFA
for
through
me,
and
yeah.
through.
But what we thank God for are the goals coming in. We've had goals coming in every match, at every stage.
And FIFA, that is the game that comes up. Please talk about it as you finalize.
Muria High School and St. Peter's. St. Peter's lost by 5-0. They looked a wanting side, but like we said, sometimes acclimatizing to a new area could be a problem to the girls, because even Ajax Queens, when they lost yesterday, they looked desperate, but today they came in stronger. But for Muria, they look strongest in the group, and you think they will have to give problems to St. Peter's. So the game comes at midday, and we anticipate a lot from it.
And of course, the neutrals would like St. Peter's to spring a surprise so that this group really opens up as we come into the deep end of this Women Elite League. I remind you, Ghanaians, it's four groups. Each has been there on its own in a bubble of sorts because of COVID-19. Group A, Group B, Group C now, then Group D will follow. The finals will be on 2nd June next month. We take a break. When we get back, it will be Amuria against St. Peter's. See you then.
We've cut and reduced our MTN Momo withdrawal rates. Now, you can withdraw mobile money at the lowest rates. You also get MTN Sentio points when you deposit, send, and withdraw MTN mobile money. Visit our Momo agents countrywide and withdraw mobile money at our reduced rates from 1st May 2021. Everywhere you go, MTN.
What does it mean to be closer together? It's taking the last bus home for a surprise visit. Closer together is strangers finding a connection. It's bringing home something much more than a box. It's the warmth of home, or the beginning of something new. There's magic in sharing the things that we learn, because it's those things that bring us close together.
Come on, everybody, put your welcome hands to the enlightened, life-changing, and world-filled broadcast brought to you by Glorious Church of Christ Ministries,
where all saints are equipped for ministry through the revelation of the new life by the one.
For the Bible says in 2 Corinthians 5:17, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. The old things are past. Behold, all things are new.
Now, join Pastor Isaac Chitwika every Sunday from 9 a.m.
to 9:30 a.m.
on UBC Television as we experience and explore this new life in God through our Lord Jesus Christ, now the Word.